Hi, it's Thomas Cook from Toronto's real estate team at REMAX, and here is our August 2013 Toronto Real Estate Market Report. August sales were up significantly over last year and even above historical monthly numbers. I'll comment more on that in this broadcast as we go through the market report. So, let's review some of the Toronto Real Estate Board statistics and see what this is all about. August MLS sales totaled 7,569 houses and condominiums in all the districts. This sales number was almost 14% above the average for the month over the last 12 years, and up 18% from 1 year ago. Remember that last summer we had the federal government reduce the amortization period down to 25 years from 30, which eliminated a lot of first-time buyers from the marketplace at that time. Condo townhouses and high-rise suites increased their share of the market slightly to 31.8%, with 2,404 units changing hands. The August average sale price for all GTA homes came in at $503,094, up 5% from 2012, and we'll comment more on that later. East of Yonge and south of Bloor in the CO8 downtown TREB district, the condo sales price average was $398,000, while west of Yonge and CO1, the average was $444,000. More condo market details will be coming in just a few minutes. The active listing inventory is one of the strongest indicators of how smooth or outrageous the market's going to be. We had a small 1-2% decline in inventory for the month of August compared to historical numbers and from last year at this time. The sales to listings or percent chance of selling ratio is how we determine what type of market we're actually in. 24-28% is a neutral market, below 24% is a buyer's market, and above 28% is a seller's market. In August, that ratio finished at 40.3%, up 7% from last year's market dip, but near or slightly above average historically for the month. We're still in moderate seller market territory. The press has reported that one of the significant reasons for higher August sales was the mortgage rate increases we've seen in the past several weeks. A 5-year rate is now at 3.49%, up about 50 basis points from what was common back 45 to 90 days ago. For every $100,000 of mortgage, that raises the monthly payment by about $27. This isn't a significant amount in the scheme of things, but some buyers may have gotten nervous and decided to get their offers in and accepted right away. More importantly, it does show that the low interest rate party is now over, and we should be expecting rates to rise, although slowly, through the next couple of years. While the overall days on market TREB average increased again by 2 days to 29, the numbers for downtown condos were about 35 days east and west of Yonge. Detached Toronto homes sold in 24 days on average, and more affordable semis were moving in 17 days. Both of these days on market times were quicker than in July. As you can see from the graph, the August average home price was again up from 1 year ago. This continues the trend we've seen for the past 20 months in Toronto and the GTA. The average sale price year-to-date is up by a modest 4.1% compared to the same period in 2012. And we should expect that the average resale price will rise again as we go through the traditionally busy fall months of September, October, and November. Downtown condo average sale prices in August were up by 14.6% in CO1 and by 2% in CO8 compared to 2012. There's always some volatility in these numbers when comparing them month by month. Condo sales numbers were up 20% in CO1 and 35% in CO8 compared to August of last year, and were even busier than some of the early spring months this year. The listing inventory was flat in CO1 and down 18% in CO8 compared to August last year. This is actually a good sign. People have been scared that we were going to be swamped with new condos going on the market, as all the new downtown buildings were being completed. We also saw the ratio of sales to listings in CO1 come up slightly to 25.8%, in neutral market territory, while CO8 east of Yonge jumped up to 43.8% into busy seller market territory. These stats are all very positive for the downtown condo market and should allay concerns about the potential for a market crash and burn. It's the continued affordability and the excitement of living right downtown near all the action that's driving people to buy into the condominium lifestyle. The second quarter rental market stats showed that the number of leased condos by up by almost 23% from 2012, with just over 5,800 suites being rented from April through June. Rents are up by about 4% year over year. If you're a condo investor or considering becoming one, the long-term rental potential and possibilities look terrific. The nice thing is, there's no grass to cut, no roofs to repair, and it's rare to get a middle-of-the-night tenant call. So how do you decide if this may be the right time for you to step into the market? The best first step always is to go on a market experience tour of condo or house neighborhoods with one of our team members. What a tour is not intended to do is to find you your dream home. What it is intended to do is to give you a clearer idea of what's available on the market in your favorite parts of the city and in your price range. Once you've had your tour, you'll be better able to set up a home buying plan and make a smart decision as to whether now is the right time for you to consider moving towards home ownership. You can sign up for your condo tour at dailydowntowncondotours.com. That's dailydowntowncondotours.com. And a tour of houses at dailytorontohometours.com. That's dailytorontohometours.com. All the best, and check back here in early October for our September Toronto Real Estate Market Report.